Transient beauty refers to the fleeting, temporary nature of certain experiences that are memorable but last only for a short period of time. This concept captures the essence of moments that are deeply beautiful yet impermanent, leaving a lasting impression because of their brevity. Just after 5 a.m., still shaking off jet lag and nearly a full day of travel, we were already on the move again. This time from Kathmandu to Helambu. Just after 2 days after landing in Nepal, by then food poisoning had hit me hard. I spent the whole night wrestling with fever and constant nausea. Despite the discomfort, life doesn't stand still. So we packed our bags and set off on a 10-day journey to my mother's village, Helambu. The roads were rough, the ride was cramped, but there was something about that moment that I knew I'd look back on with a smile. I was traveling with my extended family, reconnecting after many years apart. Being back together with my extended family after many years made the whole trip feel more like a reunion. Road trips are seriously underrated. They're a great way to really see a place as it truly is. Oh my.
Morning.
Oh my. So we have made a stop after 3 hours of ride and I just got some tea. I've just been throwing up this whole morning, so it's not easy, but now I feel much better. I think I got food poisoning, so I hope this tea helps. I'm here with my whole family and I'm so happy that we get to spend time together after such a long time. So, and I really, really missed Nepal. Let's do a taste test. Say hi, Tencho. Hi, baby. Ten out of 10. My favorite is like up and down right now. I'm not feeling well at all, but look at this view. It was heartwarming to see that despite her age, she remains healthy, active, and as social as ever. So we have finally reached here and I just took like 3-4 hours of nap. And I'm still kind of sick. Like I look really, really tired because I just woke up.
Mo,
So my grandmother is literally the cutest person ever. We call her AB, and one of the main reasons why I took this trip was for our AB, so it was really special. We got to celebrate her with our new family member, Tenzin, who is almost 2 years old.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear AB. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, you know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of like the painting, like when we were kids, our teacher used to be like, okay, draw something, and we draw mountains, it would look exactly like this, like literally like this. So it is time for me to take showers. I just heat up the water and now we're just gonna wait. But oh my god, I have the most beautiful view ever. I cannot wait to be fresh. Like literally, because I was so sick yesterday, I didn't get to take a shower. I literally came and slept for like almost like 5 hours, and everything that I ate, I literally threw up. So I'm kind of hungry, but I'm kind of scared of eating because I feel like I might throw up. But nonetheless, I feel so much better now compared to yesterday. I gotta take a shower, I gotta straighten my hair and everything, and just feel better. I just finished taking a shower and I feel so much better now. We're about to do some things that I don't know how to say, but it's like taking a blessing. And look at this. Look at the view, it's so pretty. Literally feel so much better now. It's coffee time and I'm gonna make some coffee. So we just got a blessing, you can see, and this is the food taste test.
Later that day, we headed to Kangil, a place in Helambu about an hour away from our house. The views were great, but the roads were super bumpy and I'm not great with heights, so it was a bit scary. Still, it was a fun adventure.
Where it was needed. Claim We'll always remember how it felt.
So we've reached this village called Kangil, and we just received blessing.
Look at the view. So beautiful.
We then went to see the statue of Guru Rinpoche, and I'm not an expert, but I'll just share what I've learned so far. Guru Rinpoche is a seminal figure in Tibetan Buddhism, even known as the second Buddha by some of the followers in Tibetan Buddhism. He meditated extensively, and it was a core aspect of his spiritual practice. You'll find images and statues of Guru Rinpoche in many Tibetan Buddhist temples because he played a big part in introducing Buddhism to the area. His statues often show him with a trident, which symbolizes his ability to manage spiritual forces. And sometimes he's holding a vajra, which stands for his deep and unbreakable knowledge. He spent a lot of his time meditating in various caves, which became a super important spiritual site today. I actually got to visit one of those caves, which was just an amazing experience.
I have literally the most beautiful sunset happening right behind the camera. I feel so much more peaceful, I guess. Ooh, look at the view. So that was the car that we came in, and it's dirty now because the road was really, really bumpy. But yeah, it's starting to get cold actually, but still the weather is perfect. Time to go. So you know the song, I Think I Like This Little Life. That's the only song that's playing all over my head right now. And oh my god, every angle that I look at, the sunset is so beautiful. Look at this.
Hey, kukle.
So this is our dinner. So it is kote day.
Day 2
in Helambu. I'm having my coffee and it's a pretty gloomy day today, but I am so energetic right now. And today is wedding day. I like to come here every morning and sip my coffee. Do you know its name?
No. I can see.
You can see?
Yes.
Hey, is that your line?
Oh,
good boy. I
thought you were. I
Thank you. Cheers. Okay, we got our food. Time to eat. I'm so full. The view from the top of the Gumba. Look at that. So pretty. And look at the sunset. Oh my god. The sunset is amazing. And all the people over there eating. And it's time to go because I'm freaking starving. So one thing that was kind of embarrassing was like we tried to do the dance and we failed miserably in front of everyone. So next time we gotta practice it. Good morning, it is day three. It's the day after the wedding, and yesterday the wedding was really fun. It was our first Galgobe, so it was really, really fun to watch. And the food was so yummy. Whoever the chef was just did an amazing job because I was eating the whole time. It was so spicy and so good. And now I'm just waiting for my coffee. I missed the sunrise today because I woke up pretty late. But yeah, yesterday we stayed up dancing till like 12 in the morning. So I'm obviously tired. And maybe tomorrow I'll see the sunrise. Tea and coffee time. So we're using this, and it's really
lunch time. Pakora.
So it is time for me to take shower, and I just finished heating up the water. So I just finished taking a shower, and I also washed my clothes with these bare hands, and it was not the easiest task. It was so difficult. Oh my god, I feel like my back is just, I don't even want to talk about it. But yeah, now I'm just gonna like dry my hair. I'm gonna make myself a coffee now because it's kind of cold. Finally made my coffee. Cheers. Oh yes, yeah. We are gonna do taste test of a few different candies or sweets. This is the classic choco fun. Yo choco fun. 5 out of 5. Now this is the sack choco fun. 1 out of 5. Okay. Back to the classic choco. Four out of five. Coffee break. I just tasted this and it tastes really good actually.
Something like this.
5 out of 5. So everyone's just chilling inside that kitchen. This is like one of my favorite rooms because it's so cozy and warm, and everyone's just having a great time just talking. And it's so cute to listen like my grandma and everyone talk and reconnect after like so many years. It's just so cozy. This is literally my favorite room. But yeah, right now we're about to drink tea and like have dinner, making dinner at the different kitchen. This is the kitchen that we have upstairs, and it's so, so, so cute. But yeah, it's already dark. So let's go inside.
Magpa? Hi, Manu.
Hello.
It is time to do my skincare, and it is so sunny, but and then the vitamin C. There are people working over there, so it might be a little noisy. One of the best sunscreens I've ever used. It's actually amazing. Alright, now I'm gonna go and make myself coffee and have my breakfast. So let's go.
Say hi, baby. Dinji, what is this? 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 We did it! Achoo. What is this, Dinji?
Nose.
Where is eye? What is this, Dinju? What is this, Dinju? What is this, Dinju? What is this?
Cheeks.
Cheeks.
Mama.
Mama. Right now, we just had lunch and it's time to wash these. And while I was washing my dishes earlier, I actually broke something, so the weather is like perfect right now. Sunny, clear skies. It's not that cold. The water is not that cold. So nice. Mall notice gare go. Gama basyo ni ke craving pani hundaina res.
Hai.
Uta ta hamle ke ke craving huncha ni. Yo kham yo kham haina. Kahile hot pot, kahile matcha ke ke haru. Eta ta
yeah, so the people are working over there. They're preparing for Jeju, which is I think day after tomorrow. And we're pretty useless. We're just chilling. This view. It's actually amazing. Origin.
the nose.
Pipi?
Hey.
Ki gardai?
Ekna pama basni khani. Inne sakina.
Baisi Aibi, Baisi Petunjan Aibi, Ibi Baisi Ganam Kyo.
Like, we tried to do the dance and we failed miserably in front of everyone. So next time we gotta practice it.
I'm going to go to the house.
morning. So look at this view. I just cannot get enough of this view. And they are preparing for Jeju. So it's all the preparations going on for Jeju right now. So today is a very special day. Alright, so Jeju is something that we do on the 10th day of Losar. I really cannot explain it properly what Jeju actually means. But to just summarize in a very superficial way, I guess, it's something that we do collectively, I think, to remove negative energy and like to scare away negative spirits around us. That's very superficial way of what it actually means. This is my first time actually seeing the process and everything. Now I'm an adult and I can understand these things because I might have seen it when I was a kid, like hair bits and everywhere, but I really cannot remember it. So yeah, these moments make me realize that I need to actually come back here often, but you also don't get time, you know, when you're in New York, like 2 weeks, that's it. So yeah, this is a very, very, very special trip for many, many reasons. Let's do a quick fit check.
I am obsessed with pink right now. It is currently like almost 9 p.m. and they're still dancing. Oh my god, I'm kind of sick. I don't know why, but I've just been feeling cold and everything. So, but yeah, people are still dancing. It's really fun.
Shimbu! Shimbu! Mesa! Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Doing our laundry, hand washed, and it's all over there right now. Hopefully the wind doesn't take it away, because that's what happened yesterday and it was not good. But it is such a sunny day today and it's so beautiful. Look at this. Alright, we are on our way to see Buffalo, aka Pisces. Oh my god! I'm wearing these big ass slippers. I'm about to fall, like, seriously. Let's go and meet our Pisces. Look how big my slippers are, oh my god.
What?
Memos.
It's possible.
It's my last night today, and that's the last sunset of today. So today's my last night here, and this is the last sunset. I'm gonna miss this so much. Like, I'm really gonna miss it. I'm already missing it. This trip has been so special. Fun fact, I was actually born here, over there. So, I'm so sad. But yeah, final sunset of this trip. I mean, I'm still gonna go to Kathmandu, but yeah, I'm really sad. We are on our way to the farm to see some animals.
What?
Hey. Wow, so beautiful. So we're currently at the stupa, and do you see that moon over there? So beautiful. Stay here. Literally, we're leaving today, and I don't know how like 10 days flew by. Obviously, I'm very, very sad. Oh, I don't wanna, like, I'm not prepared for this. I'm like really, really sad right now. Man, let's just take a walk. I was trying to, like, my plan for today was to wake up really early and see the sunrise, but I woke up at 7:30, and by then the I already missed it. But yeah. Do you hear that?
I love this tree because it's the only one standing over here. So it seems that our car is here, that which means we have to leave. Oh, literally so sad.
I'm going to go to the house.